Let us pray. Father God, Lord, we look to you this night, O God, truly thanking you for an opportunity to be here. Thanking you, O God, for this the privilege and an honor to be called of thee. Lord, to be schooled of thee and to know that thy truth and thy knowledge, O God. But Lord, we know that there are many needs amongst the children of God. Lord, we just ask that your hand of mercy would reach down, touch each one, touch the sick and the suffering, O God. Do that which they stand in need of, O Lord. Lord, just overshadow each one that they would know that you have looked upon them with grace and mercy, O Lord. And Lord, be with each one as we stand in this place, O God. Lord, may you just be in all things, O God. Be with my brother as he stands to deliver thy word. Give him the strength and the wisdom to say those things which are needful for us, O God. Lord, that we would be able to receive and be able to be prepared for thy day when you come to get us, O God. Lord, for we know it draweth nigh as we see this world as it gets worse and worse. But Lord, we know that thy grace abounds even more to thy children, O God. And we thank you for that. For we ask all things in Jesus Christ's name. Amen.
He is all I need. He is all I need. Oh, Jesus is all I need. Oh, he is all I need. Oh, he is all I need. Oh, Jesus is all I need. Oh, he is all I need. Oh, he is all I need. Oh, Jesus is all I need. Oh, he is all I need. Oh, he is all I need. Oh, Jesus is all I need. Oh, I will trust him now. Oh, I will trust him now for all that I need. Oh, I will trust him now. Oh, I will trust him now. Oh, he is all I need. Oh, he is all I need. Oh, Jesus is all I need. Come, Holy Spirit, I need thee. Come, Holy Spirit, I pray. Come in thy strength and thy power. Oh, come in thy own gentle way. Oh, come.
Sister Tina, you got us a song tonight? You don't have, or you do have? Okay. How about Johnson? Do y'all sing for us tonight? All right. Come right on. And Charles, you got us a song?
I was going down for the last time, but no one heard my cry. My voice was weak and fading, drifting with the tide, when a hand from out of nowhere gently slipped in mine, and I thank God. Just in time, just before the waves of slumber had rocked my soul to sleep, just before the angry billows had lured me out too deep. God knows how long I drifted before I saw that old lifeline, and I thank God. Just in time. Well, I don't
remember drifting, 'cause pleasure rolled with me. When careless winds are blowing, you drift so easily. But storms make no exception, and friend, I've sure had mine, and I thank God he found me just in time, just before the waves of slumber had rocked my soul to sleep, just before the angry billows had lured me out too deep. God knows how long I drifted before I stole that old lifeline, and I thank God he found me just in time, just before the waves of slumber had rocked my soul to sleep, just before the angry billows had lured me out too deep. God knows how long I drifted before I stole that old lifeline, and I thank God he found me just in time.
Praise the Lord tonight. All right, brother.
After a while we'll all be over, and our journey here will end. And soon we'll view the heavenly portals, and a new day will begin. Then we'll join the choir of angels, singing out the victory song. Some sweet day we're going over, and we'll live with heaven's throng. Oh, just a little while to stay here, just a little while to wait, just a little while to labor in the path that's always straight. Just a little trials and troubles in this meek and lowly state, and then we'll enter heaven's portals, sweeping through the pearly gates. Soon we see the light of morning, then the new day will begin. Soon we'll hear the Father calling, come my children, enter in. Then we'll hear the choir singing, singing out the victory song. All our troubles will be ended, and we'll live with heaven's throng. Just a little while to stay here, just a little while to wait, just a little while to labor in the path that's always straight. Just a few more trials and troubles in this meek and lowly state, and then we'll enter heaven's glory, sweeping through the pearly gates. And soon we'll meet again our loved ones, and we'll take them by the hand. Soon we'll press them to our bosom, over in the promised land. Then we'll be at home forever, throughout all eternity. What a blessed, blessed morning that eternal morn shall be. Just a little while to stay here, just a little while to wait, just a little while to labor in the path that's always straight. Just a few more trials and troubles in this meek and lowly state, and then we'll enter heaven's portals, sweeping through the pearly gates. Just a little while to stay here, just a little while to wait, just a little while to labor in the path that's always straight. Just a few more trials and troubles in this meek and lowly state, and then we'll enter heaven's portals, sweeping through the pearly gates.
Thank you for that tonight. All right, you all come on. And Sister Matters, you got a song?
I thought number one would always be me. I thought I could be all I wanted to be. I thought I could live on life's sinking sand. But I can't even walk without you holding my hand. Oh Lord, I can't even walk without you holding my hand. The mountains too high, the land, the valley. Could do a lot on my own. I thought I could make it all alone. I thought of myself as a mighty big man, but I can't. Without you holding my hand. Oh Lord, I can't even walk without you holding my hand. The mountains too high, oh, and the valleys too wide. Without you holding my hand, the is where I've learned to stand, but I can't even walk without you holding my hand.
Thank you for that, Sister Matters. Would you come on this time, please? And Brother Kevin, Sister Sandy, y'all have a song for us? And Sister Diane singing with her, so that's good.
We're going to practice on you all. We've never sang this song together, so I've never sang it by myself either. So pray for us. When the Savior calls, I will answer. When he calls for me, I will hear. When the Savior calls, I will answer. I'll be somewhere listening for my name. I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening for my name. I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening for my name. If my heart is right when he calls me, if my heart is right, I will hear. If my heart is right when he calls me, I'll be I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening for my name. I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening for my name. If my robe is white when he calls me, if my robe is white, I will hear. If my robe is white when he calls me, I'll be somewhere listening for my name. I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening for my name. I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening for my name. Yes, I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening for my name. I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening. I'll be somewhere listening for my name.
All right, y'all come on.
good to be here tonight. And we thank the Lord for the rain. I'm getting plenty of rain. And I remember back last year, and it seems like every summer we kind of get in a drought situation. So be thankful for the rain while we have it, and God will take care of the rest. We'll sing this song for Brother Smith tonight. He came up to me before the service, and he said, "Do you know how to sing this song?" And we do. So, Brother Smith, this song's for you tonight.
I look and see earth's golden riches, I'm hoarding up for selfish gain, the toll of time. The Savior's calling, the grain is falling. Oh, do not wait, it's growing late. Behold, the fields are wide, it's harvest time. Oh, do not sleep while souls are dying. Awake, arise, there's much to do. For if you try hard to win them, God will surely be a blessing to you. Harvest time, harvest time, the Savior's calling, the grain is falling. Oh, do not wait, it's growing late. Behold, the fields are white, it's harvest time. Sin not for months, then comes the harvest. For ripe the grain is ready to yield. Work now while day, for night is coming. I look again and see the falling golden grain. It's harvest time, harvest time. The Savior's calling, the grain is falling. Oh, do not wait, for it's growing late. Behold, the fields are wide, it's harvest time. And when I stand harvest time, harvest time, the Savior's calling, the grain is falling. Oh, do not wait, it's growing late. Behold, the fields are wide, it's harvest time.
Is. We see the things that are going on. A year ago, they had election in Egypt. Now then, Obama's man is fallen. So we see men raised to the heights, we see them go to the lowest. So we praise the Lord tonight for his wonderful grace to us. Let's just stand, please, if we would. Turn the service over to Brother Bud. May the Lord bless our brother.
That he allowed us to be able to come together and to have fellowship and to worship him. Let us all bow our heads. Gracious, loving Heavenly Father, we bow in your presence. And Father, we thank you for this great privilege that you have granted to us to be able to come together, to have fellowship, and to worship you in spirit and in truth. Father, I again ask that you will anoint this vessel of clay as I stand here before these precious brothers and sisters to minister your word which you have laid upon my heart. Father, I ask that everything will be pleasing unto you. And Father, I pray that you will bless my precious brothers and sisters. And we pray for those that are standing in need of a touch from you. Father, may you comfort them. May you minister to their needs according to your perfect will. Father, we commit everything into your hands. And we humbly ask this in the precious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. All right, you may be seated. I'm on a different subject tonight. I'm titling it Peace, Joy, and Happiness. Like Brother Allen said, we can see the signs that we are at the end of this grace age period of time. And it won't be long till our Lord will be coming back. And I hope and pray that all are ready for his coming. I'm going to go to Isaiah, the 9th chapter. I'm going to just read verse 6. For unto us a child is born, unto us a son is given, and the government shall be upon his shoulder, and his name shall be called Wonderful Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ suffered and died for the peace that we are to have. Thank you, brother. He went through a lot so that we could have peace of mind and joy in our hearts and happiness through the Lord. I'm going to go to Isaiah, the 53rd chapter. Verses 3 through 7. He is despised and rejected of men, a man of sorrows and acquainted with grief. And we hid, as it were, our faces from him. He was despised, and we esteemed him not. Surely he hath borne our griefs and carried our sorrows. Yet we did esteem him stricken, smitten of God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. All we like sheep have gone astray. We have turned every one to his own way, and the Lord hath laid on him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed, and he was afflicted. Yet he opened not his mouth. He is brought as a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before her shears is dumb, so he openeth not his mouth. Brothers and sisters, the Lord Jesus Christ went through a lot to pay for our salvation and to pay for our peace of mind and our joy and happiness. I'm going to read that fifth verse again. But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him. And with his stripes we are healed. As I said just a minute ago, Jesus Christ paid a great price for our salvation, for our healing, and for the peace that we have from the Lord. Go to the book of Psalms, the 22nd chapter. It don't matter what we are going through with. If it's financial trouble, sickness, whatever it is, God can give us the peace and the joy and the happiness that we stand in need of. Brothers and sisters, if we look to Him and humble ourselves before Him in prayer, He can give us the peace and the joy and the happiness that we all stand in need of. Psalms 22, verses 13 through 18. They gaped upon me with their mouths as a ravening and a roaring lion. I am poured out like water, and all my bones are out of joint. My heart is like wax. It is melted in the midst of my bowels. My strength is dried up like a potsherd, and my tongue cleaveth to my jaws. And Thou hast brought me into the dust of death. For dogs have compassed me. The assembly of the wicked have enclosed me. They pierced my hands and my feet. I may tell all my bones, they look and stare upon me. They part my garments among them and cast lots upon my vesture. See what He went through for our peace and joy and happiness? I cannot go explain what He really went through, but He suffered for our peace of mind. He suffered for our joy, and He suffered for our happiness. Brothers and sisters, Jesus Christ paid a great price, not only for the saving of your soul, but for the healing of your bodies and for the joy and peace and happiness and comfort of mind. Now let us go to the 5th chapter of the book of Romans. Verses 1 through 5. What shall we say then that Abraham our father, as pertaining to flesh, hath found? For if Abraham were justified by works, he hath whereof to glory, but not before God. For what saith the Scripture? Abraham believed God, and it was counted unto him for righteousness. Now to him that worketh is the reward not reckoned of grace, but of debt. But to him that worketh not, but believeth on him that justifieth the ungodly, his faith is counted for righteousness. And I think I wrote that down by mistake. Oh, I was reading chapter 4. Okay. Chapter 5. Therefore, being justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, by whom also we have access by faith into this grace, wherein we stand and rejoice in hope of the glory of God. And not only so, we glory in tribulations also, knowing that tribulation worketh patience, and patience experience, and experience hope, and hope maketh not ashamed, because the love of God is shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Ghost, which is given unto us. I'm going to read that first verse again. Therefore, being justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. I'm going to go to Romans 15. I know I'm reading a lot. I'm just going to read verse 13. Now the God of hope fill you with all joy and peace in believing, that ye may abound in hope through the power of the Holy Ghost. The God of hope fill you with all joy and peace. Brothers and sisters, our Heavenly Father can give us the peace of mind and comfort of heart and joy and happiness that we all stand in need of. No matter what we are going through with, whether it's sickness or some other bad trial or test, God, our Heavenly Father, can give us the peace that we stand in need of. And He can give us the joy when things come upon us. There can be joy in our hearts. If we live according to His Word. I'm going to say this. Some people don't have peace and joy and happiness because they are not conforming to the Word of God. Brothers and sisters, if we listen to the true ministry that is bringing forth the Word of God, how we are to conduct ourselves and how we are to live, we can have peace of mind. Galatians chapter 5. Verse 22. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance. Against such there is no law. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, and peace. The fruit of the Spirit of God is joy and love and peace. I'm going to go to the book of Philippians, the fourth chapter. Verses 6 through 9. Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your request be made known unto God. And the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your request be made known unto God. And the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue, and if there be any praise, think on these things. Those things which ye have both learned and received and heard and seen in me do, and the God of peace shall be with you. Brothers and sisters, if we abide by the Word of God, and if we obey what is in His Word, He will give us the peace that we stand in need of. I wasn't going to say this, but I feel compelled to say it. I don't want any of you to raise your hands or nod your head. But how many of you would let people come into your house cursing? Then why do you watch television shows that have cursing on them? I'll read these verses again. Be careful for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication with thanksgiving, let your request be made known unto God, and the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. Finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are pure, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue, and if there be any praise, think on these things. Those things which ye have heard, or those things which ye have both learned and received and heard and seen in me do, and the God of peace shall be with you. Brothers and sisters, there is so much filth on TV. You better be careful what you watch. If people are cussing and dressing filthy on TV, you shouldn't watch that show. Don't bring your little children up like that. Colossians, the third chapter. Mm-hmm. the 15th verse. And let the peace of God rule in your hearts, to the which also ye are called in one body, and be ye thankful. Let the peace of God rule in your hearts. Brothers and sisters, God can give all of His children the peace of mind that they stand in need of, if we will obey the Word of God. I wasn't going to read verse 1, but I'm going to read down through that third chapter. If ye then be risen with Christ, seek those things which are above, where Christ sitteth on the right hand of God. Set your affections on things above, not on things of the earth. For ye are dead, and your life is hid with Christ in God. When Christ, who is our life, shall appear, then shall ye also appear with Him in glory. Mortify therefore your members which are upon the earth: fornication, uncleanliness, inordinate affection, evil concupiscence, and covetousness, which is idolatry, for which things' sake the wrath of God cometh on the children of disobedience, in the which ye also walked sometime when ye lived in them. But now ye also put off all of these: anger, wrath, malice, blasphemy, filthy communication out of your mouth. Lie not one to another, seeing that ye have put off the old man with his deeds. And I realize I just read that in the last message, but I felt compelled to read it again as I was going through that 15th verse. And have put on the new man, which is renewed in knowledge after the image of Him that created him. Brothers and sisters, we are to walk in the newness of life if we have been saved by the grace of God. Let's go to the book of Isaiah, the 26th chapter. Verses 3 and 4. Thou wilt keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is stayed upon thee, because he trusteth in thee. Trust ye in the Lord forever.
ever For in the Lord Jehovah is everlasting strength. Brothers and sisters, if we obey the Word of God and live according as the Holy Spirit leads us and guides us, we can have peace with God. Through our Lord Jesus Christ. As I said, I'm doing a lot of reading, and I'm going to let you go a little bit early. Go with me to the book of John, the 14th chapter. Verse 27. Peace I leave with you. This is Jesus' words. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give unto you. Not as the world giveth, give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. Brothers and sisters, as I said before, Jesus Christ paid a great price for the peace that we stand in need of. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give unto you. Not as the world giveth, give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. The world is talking about world peace. There will never be world peace until the eternal age. But we as children of God can have peace in our hearts. And we can have joy unspeakable and full of glory. And happiness if we obey the Word of God. Now, for my last scripture, Psalms. The 29th chapter. Verse 11. The Lord will give strength unto His people. The Lord will bless His people with peace. God will bless His children with peace. No matter what you are going through with, if you seek the Lord, if you humble yourself before Him, if you obey His Word, He will give you the peace that you stand in need of. Brothers and sisters, we can have peace, joy, and happiness if we obey the Word of God.
Well, I'm finished with this message. Gracious Heavenly Father, I thank You again for the peace that You have given unto Your children, and for the joy and the happiness. Father, we pray that You will continue to lead us and to direct us by Your precious Spirit. And Father, we know that You will, if we will be obedient unto Your precious Word. Father, I pray for my precious brothers and sisters that You will comfort them. And Father, I pray that You will lead us and guide us all in the way that You would have us to go, and we know that You will. Father, we commit everything into Your hands, and we humbly pray this in the precious name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen. Turn the service back over to Brother Allen.
Tonight, a message of peace that I'm sure that we can all apply to ourselves, that it's something that is needed within us at all time, and we thank the Lord for the peace of God that passes understanding. We don't fully understand it all, but it's there for our help and benefit. Thank you, Brother. All right, Brother David, come on if you would, and we'll stand, and if anybody has need, then you feel free to come.
Oh, peace, peace. Oh, wonderful peace. Coming down from the Father above. Sweep over my spirit forever, I pray. Infathomless billows of love. Oh, peace, peace, oh, wonderful peace, coming down from the Father above. Oh, sleep over my spirit, forever. Shine on me, oh, shine on me. Let the light from God's lighthouse shine on me, oh, shine on me, Oh, shine on me. Oh, let the light, oh, from God's lighthouse, shine on me. Oh, shine on me. Oh, shine on me. Oh, let the light from God's lighthouse shine on me. Oh, shine on me. Oh, shine on me. Let the light, oh, from God's lighthouse shine on me.
Praise the Lord. Y'all remember each other and pray that none of you have to float home, because it's really rained a lot. I know it has, and water could be up in places. So we want to always remember our brothers and sisters in prayer. So may the Lord bless you and have a good week, and remember the service is Sunday. Brother Jerry, would you pray as we're dismissed?